Hi guys, this is my last video for the week and I just want to walk you through a couple things, which is a variation on a theme we've already had this week by Ann Williamson, so which involves making clay charms. Now this is just scrap clay. It actually was a few different colors. I've kneaded it together so much that it's just become this brown tan color, and that's fine. I'm going to break off a blob and I am going to roll it out. Here I'm working on this cookie sheet. This is a cookie sheet that's dedicated to crafting, so don't use things from your kitchen for your crafting tools. I got this at the dollar store. You don't need to spend a lot of money. And this is polymer clay. I don't want it too thick, but I don't want it too thin either. And then once I have a piece that I think is going to work, then I'm going to take one of my embossing folders. Anne talked about this in her video. And I'm going to take the deeper etched side of it. If you've worked with embossing folders before, you know what I mean. And I'm actually going to put it like over, this is a flower one. I'm going to put it over the flower center. And then I'm going to roll the clay into the embossing folder with my, oops, roller. Okay, well, good thing that I got a pretty good impression there because I stuck to the roller. So I end up with that. I'm going to turn it pretty side up and I'm going to take my X-Acto knife and I'm going to cut a heart, hand cut a heart shape. And remove the extra clay. Then I'm going to take either my finger or I have one of these little clay tools with the little knobs, oops, little knobs on the end. And I'm going to fix any issues with the edges, make them a little less sharp with either the tool or honestly, I found the easiest thing to do is just push around the edge slightly with my finger. Okay, and you end up with something like that. So I want to make a couple of them, different ones. I have one more embossing folder I want to do. I have this one, which is, these are all Durice folders. They're really inexpensive, and so I like to buy them. This is a flower one. I have this one, which is another flower one. And then I have this swirly one, which I want to do. So let's roll out one more piece of clay. I'll just put the whole blob down there. I'm actually going to move that so I don't take a chance of damaging the hearts I've already got on there. I'm going to put this on the embossing folder. Let's see. Which side is the... I think I want to do this side. If you do it wrong, the clay is not baked yet, so it's not a big deal. Oh yeah, that's great. Look at that. Okay. And I'm gonna cut this one over. No, I'm gonna cut it on the tray. Then I don't have to move it. Okay. Let's cut this piece in half. Might be able to get two hearts out of it, which would be fantabulous. The clay is not baked or dried or permanently formed yet, so if you make a mistake, it's not a big deal. Just pick it up, wad it back up into a ball, and try again. I am going to fix... Can you see what I'm doing? You can't see what I'm doing. I'm off camera. So I'm going to fix these edges here that are kind of funky down here at the bottom. I'm going to try. Actually, I wonder if I can. Let's see. Yeah. So I don't necessarily want them to be perfect, but I don't want them to be too rough either. Now, of course, if I had heart-shaped cookie cutters, this would be easier, but I don't. So the point of this is to use what you have and make things for your journals and your projects using what you have. I like that one. Let's see. And using the embossing folders leaves you with something more interesting than just a straight, flat heart when we're all done. And don't worry about what color your clay is or anything like that, because it doesn't matter. And you'll see why. So I'm going to cut one last heart, then I'm going to bake these, and I'll be back. Okay, so I'm going to show you here what I did. I already baked our clay pieces, and now we're going to make molds of them. If you don't want the texture of the clay itself to be in there, which is going to give you a rough, like almost stone-like texture in your mold, then you probably want to coat this with some sort of glaze or polymer and let it dry really thoroughly before you make your mold. I don't care about that, so I'm going to be fine. And I'm going to show you first how to make the mold. I'm going to take my clay piece and my glue dots, which are on the table somewhere. I have a little strip. I don't know. They disappeared. They're just gone. Of course, they're on a piece of clear plastic, so they could be anywhere. Oh, that is way too strange. Okay, well, I have more glue dots. These are repositionable glue dots. You could probably hot glue it down if you wanted. I'm going to just use glue dots. I just put three on the back of each one of these clay pieces. Now that I'm doing it on camera, the glue dot doesn't want to stick. Because, you know, that's how it works. That's how we roll. Okay, and this is just a piece of, you know, acrylic from my local plastics shop. I'm actually going to clean this off a little bit. The silicone, this is a silicone mold, and it doesn't stick to the acrylic. So I'm going to push this down really carefully, really thoroughly. Now, if you have extras of the silicone mold material in your mixing bowl or cup, it's not going to stick, see? It just comes right out. This is what from the molds I just did off camera. So I'm going to take this blob of dried silicone and stick it in the trash can. So you can, of course, use something disposable, but you can also just reuse the container. Now I want to get two clean sticks. And I'm going to take equal amounts of both of the materials. Now this is from Environmental Technologies product Easy Mold, which is a silicone paste. I think it's a little bit easier to get a finished detail mold with this material than it is the putty version of this type of mold making material. I've tried both. I prefer this one. For detailed molds, anyway. You, of course, could weigh this and be really precise about it. I'm not actually going to. I'm going to just eyeball it, which is probably the wrong thing to do. You probably should weigh it, and I do actually have a scale off camera, and I'm just being lazy. So if you don't get the amounts of each material exactly right, it may take a little longer to dry. So now you just want to mix them thoroughly until there's no white specks and it's just all a solid color. And really scrape your container and make sure that you've got, and scrape your stick, make sure you've got all the little bits and pieces mixed in really thoroughly. You have about 20 to 30 minutes of drying time. Okay, and then I'm going to take a disposable glue brush like this. You probably can get this kind of thing in the hobby section of your craft store, where they have like the model cars and stuff, I would think. So I'm going to take some of this silicone mold making material and I'm going to kind of lightly brush a thin coat around the sides of my clay piece and over the top, kind of swirling it into the cracks in the clay of the embossed design. I'm also going to make sure that I turn this around so I can make sure that I'm seeing and truly getting all the edges so we have a good seal around the edge. I have one here, this one, that I actually missed a spot, so we're going to add the scraps of silicone mold material here to the little hole that's in the edge of that one. Okay, once you have all the edges down, then you can really just kind of just mound it on the top, making sure, of course, that you get all of the clay piece covered up. And because my clay is brown and the mold material is blue, in theory, it should be pretty easy to know if you've covered it all up correctly because there won't be any more brown showing. Although, as I said, I did miss a spot on that one. And what I was doing too is kind of periodically scraping the glue brush with my mixing stick and scraping the sides of the bowl to try to really just use all of the material that I could. It takes, like I said, about 20 or 30 minutes to dry. And once it is dry, then you can peel it off. It should peel right off. Okay, I am going to take some of this extra. I'm going to stuff it in the little hole I have over here on this other one. Hopefully the demo one I have to pull off, which is this one, pulls off. And there's no issues, so we'll find out. Okay, so we're gonna let all that dry. These are trash, and but I'm gonna leave the stick in here to pull to scrape the bowl with, and this can just be thrown away. These are really inexpensive. All right, so then once it's dry, which this one is dry to the touch, then you can just lift the edges. It's not going to stick to the clay or the plastic, and that one wasn't quite dry in the middle. stick that down there and see if it sticks, if it dries more. I'll be right back. Okay, so once it's dry, and I would just recommend not being impatient like I am, and just let it go. Let it sit for at least 30 minutes, if not longer. It should peel right up. And you'll have a fairly nice impression of your clay heart inside of this a new flexible silicone mold. You can take some scissors and trim some of the excess little wispy bits off. And now I have 6 new molds. This one's a little thin on the edge, so you really kind of want to make sure that you get enough of the mold putty, or the mold silicone paste on there. That one, so what I do is I take my molds, and the next time I'm making a mold, I take the little bit of extra that's in the bowl, and I fix holes in them, like in this one, because it'll stick to itself really well. Okay, so I'm going to get these all trimmed, and then really quickly I'm going to show you how to use another product to make some more hearts. I'll be right back. Okay, once you have your molds made, you can use paper clay in them. You can use all kinds of things. And I'm going to actually use, though, some resin. This is fast cast, again, by Environmental Technologies. It dries really quickly, 10 minutes. And there's little or no odor, which means I can use it without wheezing. And I am going to take precautions. You're still working with chemicals, and we're going to put gloves on. You really don't want to get this on your skin. And before this resin actually dries white, not clear, and before we do anything, we are going to coat the inside of our molds with some mica powders. These are magicals. Yeah, Lindy's Stamp Gain magicals. So these were a gift from my dear friend Cindy Utter, and I just got 3 different kind of shades of pinky colors that she gave me. This is Wild Honey, Peony Scarlet, and Opaline Rosy. So like a tanny rose, like a pink, and like this peachy color. So I'm going to just brush these lightly on the inside of the molds. Probably like 2 or more, you know, colors per. I don't know exactly what, you know, these colors are going to look like after they're molded. I'm just playing and experimenting. It's just, you know, a fun experiment. These would be great to make and then turn them into jewelry or some sort of planner charm. Maybe drill a hole in them after they're dry. And, you know, gift them to your friends, loved ones, art pals, things like that. Of course, you could have a big stash of them that you save to do art with. Make them ahead of time. Okay. So before we do anything else, we're going to close these because I'm really worried I'm going to spill them everywhere. And it's going to make a big mess. Okay, and I have, since these molds aren't flat, I have them sitting on little bags of BB shot. You could balance them on something else so that they are fairly flat and even, so that when you put the resin in, you get a nice even pour. All right, now this is of course a two-part mixing thing. So we are going to put A in my little tiny mixing container, and then an equal part of B. And I'm gonna use this half. This is, again, measuring spoons I just use for crafting. I don't use them for anything else. Especially once you use something like this for either the silicone paste or for resin, you can't use it for food again then. This lid's kind of stuck. Let's see. There we go. So then we'll put an equal amount of B. And again, the resin that dries on there should lift right out of that plastic. You have 10 minutes to work with this. I'm going to stir it quickly. It'll start to get warm and thick. The drying time, hardening time will, of course, vary depending on where you're at, the weather, and other conditions that you're at. You need to stir it for about 30 seconds. You feel this bottom start to get warm, that's usually time when it's a good time to pour it. I am by no means a resin expert. There are other channels on YouTube that are much better with resin than I am. I will try to remember to link one of my favorites in the description below. I actually may not have enough resin for that last one. Nope. I need to mix a little bit more. As it dries, it's going to turn white and opaque. It will not stay clear. And again, depending on where you are in the world, what your weather conditions are like, how hot it is, how humid it is, it may have a longer or shorter drying time. So I'm going to get this last one poured, and then we will be back when they're dried and unmolded, and we will see what we get. Look around your, and I already had all of this stuff. I just hadn't really done any playing with it. So the lesson here that we've been trying to show you, not only this month, but so far in the program, is to look around and see what you have and how you can use that to create some interesting embellishments, not only in your My Year 2017 journal, but in your art going forward. Let's break some of those things out of the boxes that we've bought in the past thinking we wanted to try them, and then you know what? We never did. Let's get them out of the box, let's use them, and see what happens. All right, I will be back. It hasn't been 10 minutes yet, but look how, see how they're turning white? That's what I meant. So when they're completely white, I'm going to give him a good 10 minutes, if not a little bit longer. We'll be back and we'll unmold him and we'll see what we've got. All right, I'll be back. Okay, so one thing I want to show you is the bowl. See, did indeed all come out clean. And our little clay pieces, all the leftover little random bits of the silicone mold making putty all came off. So they can, of course, be used to make more molds, or they can just be used as is on a future project. I do have a little drawer full of clay bits and pieces that I will probably put these into. And these are here's our little mixing thing. Well, that should all peel out of there. I don't know if these are completely dry. I noticed this one, evidently I missed a spot. So some of it leaked out onto my little bean bag, which is fine. So what I'll probably do on this one is I'll set this mold aside, and the next time I'm making molds, I'll stuff that hole up with some more of the blue paste. But let's see what the heart looks like. Should pop out. Well, it might be a little difficult to pop out because of the part where it leaked. Oh, not too bad, actually. So there is a little bit extra here, so I can take some scissors while it's not completely hard and just give it a little trim. You can also let it harden completely, which it's not, and you can, you know, sand the edges. I kind of like the kind of rough nature of that. Now, as far as the part where there's a hole, and we've got, you can't leave this here and then make more molds because it's going to stick to whatever more resin you put in here, but we do have a hole that will have to be plugged up. Let's try the next one. Now you can use this fast cast in any silicone mold, so if you have like the cake molds or any store-bought molds. Again, give it any roughness that's on it. You can tell it's not completely hardened because it's a little bit flexible. When it's hardened, it will be not, it won't be flexible. So that one is fine. And I probably could and should be leaving these in here a little longer, but I'm not going to. And if you want them to be more colored, then you, of course, put more magicals inside the mold. But I kind of like this sort of distressed, uneven look of them. And you, of course, can paint them. So maybe you put some magicals in there and you molded some, you pulled them out, and you thought, well, they're not really as pink as I would like, or they're not the exact color I would like. You can use any number of supplies in your stash, including your acrylic paints, to paint them. Oh, this one doesn't seem to want to come out. Might not be dry enough. Let's see. Nope, nope, I got it. Got it. Again, you could be a lot more patient than I'm being. Like that one. There's something about that one I like. I don't know. And I'm going to show you what I mean by some paint, because I do think we're going to add a little more color to them. And again, you could do this with anything. Maybe you have key molds. Maybe you have... It actually looks like some of the putty is stuck in the cracks. Maybe you have some other shaped mold that you want to do this with. There's dirt or something in this. Hang on. Yep. So now we're going to zoom in. I'm going to move some things out of my way here. Put those there. Put these back here. We got 5 carts because remember, one mold didn't quite make it. So let's zoom in just a little bit. Let me grab something really quick. And let's see. I was kind of hoping, as I said really quick, that I actually knew where it was, but I did. Yay! Woohoo! I think I only have 2 colors. Oh no, 3 colors. These are Inca Golds. Hopefully they're not dried up, so we'll find out here in a second. I have red, green, and gold. Let's try the red one. Oh no, they're not dried up. And I'm gonna just use my finger. Are we zoomed in enough, maybe? Really lightly. Just to kind of hit the high spots. And the edges. And this is a gold one. I put baby wipes inside of these to keep them from drying out. It does really work, and it does not make them moldy. At least I've never had a problem with that. But this is another way to color your resin, and you could do just this, like cast them white and do just this, or you could, like I said, and I've done, you could put the magicals in there, and then go back and add some Inca Gold. Now they demonstrated this fast cast at Creativation in Phoenix, and I fell in love with it there. I will put the link to Environmental Technologies in the description below. It is their products, their Easy Cast at least is available, pretty readily available. You can of course order it from their website and on a bunch of other places. I'm not going to use the green because, you know, these are hearts, and the green just doesn't seem appropriate. Again, don't go buy new things. Use what you have to create something interesting. You can tint the resin to a color before you get started. So you can, instead of letting it be white, you can tint it to be any one of a number of colors, including black. So there you go. I don't know which lid goes to which now. Oh, this one goes here. All right, so that's it. Let me move these so they're, there we go. Now this should come out of here pretty easily. Yep, see? Just peels right off. See? Peels right off so you can use this container again to mix more resin. Alrighty, I'm gonna throw that away. That's it for today and for the week. I hope you've enjoyed this weekend that all of and this month, and all of the teachers and I have given you some great ideas of what you can do in your My Year journal and with your art in general. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please let us know. If you're not a member of the My Year 2017 Facebook group, the link to that and a bunch of other stuff, like I have said, is in the description below. We would be happy to have you join us. It's a free, safe place to do and share art. And that's it for right now. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you can. And look, see, I painted, just inadvertently painted one of the clay ones. that's okay. So don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you can. And to support my channel by maybe thinking about shopping over in my Etsy shop. Again, the link is in the description below. The most important thing, of course, though, is have a great day. And play with your supplies. See what you have and what you can make. And have some fun. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it. I'll see you later. Bye, guys.